Well, welcome back to our feature story tonight, and it's all about the flu and the vaccine. Other parts of the world have already been hit pretty badly by the flu, which means that we could be in for a rough season ourselves, and the flu shot still remains our best protection. My special guest is joining me right now. I want you to meet Dr. Suraj Saggar. He is the chief of infectious disease, Holy Name Medical Center. Thanks for being here, doctor.
Thanks,
it's
Ernie.
A big subject. A lot of people keep talking about it this time of year. Let me start with this. Is the vaccine for everyone?
Ernie, since 2010, the recommendation has been for universal flu vaccination. In other words, anyone older than 6 months should get their flu
shot. Should get the flu
shot. Absolutely.
There are some high-risk groups as well. You know, you start talking about pregnant women, the elderly, and so forth. Tell us about those.
Well, there are certain groups that are at more risk than others. Like you alluded to, older than 65, pregnancy, chronic medical conditions, those that may have impaired immune systems, or less than the age of 5. But the reality is anyone can be affected, and anyone can suffer what we call severe secondary infections, including bacterial pneumonia. So even those that don't fit those risk factors should be
vaccinated. You really should be doing this, right?
Absolutely.
There are some myths, okay? There are some people who say, look, I got the shot last year. Do I really need it again this year?
Yes.
How do you answer that?
This is very common.
Yeah.
The flu is caused by influenza virus. It's a very tricky virus. It changes from year to year.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, you may be protected for one particular season. Doesn't mean you're protected for the next season.
Right.
So we look to surveillance data from what's going on in the southern hemisphere, in Asia, and make our best estimations of what type of viral subtype will be circulating. But this requires an annual influenza vaccination.
And Dr. Saggar, I know you hear this a lot. People will say, I got the shot and I got the flu.
Absolutely.
I got sick from this thing. I'm not taking it
anymore. I hear about this
all the time in my
practice. And the reality and the short answer is this. All the available vaccines that are available contain what we call inactivated influenza. The virus is killed by either chemicals or by heat. There's no way for these viral particles to redevelop into a live virus. So you cannot get influenza from the vaccine. Having said that, sure, you can have side effects.
Some side effects, right.
Most common being an injection reaction, some soreness in your arm.
That can happen.
And even some people can have flu-like symptoms for a day or two after getting the vaccine. This is not the flu. This is your immune system being ramped up.
Mm-hmm.
You can think of another way. This is showing the vaccine is doing its job.
When's the best time to get the shot?
So, great question, Ernie.
Yeah.
Typically, the season goes from October until May. Obviously, colder weather, people are grouped indoors.
So it's not too late, right?
It's never too late. In my practice, I tell people to get their vaccination by the end of October.
Mm-hmm.
It usually peaks in February. Having said that, it's never too late, as you said, to get the vaccination.
And you can always get it a lot of places, too, right? You get it at your doctor, you can go to different health stores and so forth.
That's not the issue. The availability of the vaccine has never been an issue. It's just getting the general public to be aware of this disease, to understand and appreciate how severe the disease can be, and to get vaccinated.
Let's stay healthy. Dr. Saggar, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Okay, good information.